Hello, my name is Arnold van Vliet. I'm a biologist at Wageningen University in the Netherlands, and I use the GrowApp to study the impact of climate change on nature.
Hello, I'm Lenka Hajková, and I'm dealing with Phenology at the Czech Hydrometeorological Institute.
Hi everyone, my name is Zorana Sedlar, and I am a plant ecologist working at the Croatian Natural History Museum in Zagreb.
Using GrowApp is not very difficult. You first have to install it on your phone. So go to growapp.today where you find the links to the different app stores. Next thing you do is make photo positions. So you go to a location where you want to track changes in nature over time and then making photographs. So make sure that you can easily recognize that location the next time you go there. So when you've made a photo location, the location is directly added to the map of the GrowApp. The next time, that can be the next day or the next week, you go to that specific location. The map directs you where you have to go. You click on that photo location and the previous image or an existing time-lapse video is automatically opened. On the right bottom, you see a pictogram where you can click on. Then the first photo of the series is presented in a transparent way. You can click and you can make a nice overlay with your new picture. Then when you add a new picture, an example is given, and you can add remarks by clicking at the bottom of the picture. And you can add, for example, hashtag with the school name or hashtag with the species name that you have made a photograph of. The next thing you do is upload that picture, and it directly creates a new time-lapse video with the new picture added to that. And if you do that over and over again, you see a nice change over time in your time-lapse video and together with the dates on which you made those pictures. And this is wonderful material to use for your research.
I'm standing here in front of a birch tree. I guess you recognize it by now. One of seven species, tree species, we chose for the GrowApp campaign for phenology tracking. Other six species include oak, hazel, beech, lime, cherry, and the new added species, fig. All seven species are chosen because of their wide distribution throughout Europe, which gives us the possibility of comparing their reaction to climate on the south of Europe and also on the northern parts, including also the central Europe.
What for can we use the phenological observations? We use it into the phenological models, and these models are used in agriculture, in natural sciences, in medicine. In medicine, for example, for the allergology purposes, and of course in a climate change research. What did we found in our results? We found out that the spring phases, it means beginning of flowering or leaf unfolding, comes earlier. There is a shift of days to the earlier dates. And on the other side, in autumn, we found out that the phases comes later. It's important to have many records of phenological observation. And the autumn is in front of us. You can observe yellowing and leaf falls in your countryside. You are warmly welcome to the Phenological Network. Sense locked.